In this tutorial, I'll show you how to animate liquid transitions in literally just a few minutes. Hi, my name is Manuel, I'm a freelance motion designer. To follow along, you might want to download the project file. It includes three different transitions. Right now, let's create a transition moving from top to bottom. First of all, let's add a solid by pressing Command Y. Color doesn't matter, I'll keep it black and white. By the way, my comp is 1920 by 1080. We name the solid transition in. The solid selected, we grab the rectangle tool from the toolbar up here and add a mask like that. It basically splits the screen in half. It's the liquid transition halfway down to the bottom. Now let's grab the pen tool and add some more points along the bottom line. I'm adding 10 points to be exact. I'll quickly change the mask color to make things more visible for you guys. By pressing V, we change to the selection tool. Now let's move these points up, down, up, down. You get the system, right? It should look kind of random. Let's select the Convert Vertex tool and round all lower points by dragging the handles. And if you hold Shift while dragging them, they move in a straight horizontal line. Very convenient. Some little adjustments. This is our main shape. As you might think already, this is more like a traditional animation project and not really effects driven. At 5 frames in the timeline, we add a keyframe for the shape mask. Next, let's move to the beginning of our timeline and move the mask up, above the screen. And again, if you hold Shift while moving, it's a straight vertical line. Then let's adjust the mask a little to have some kind of, let's say, evolvement in the shape. Next, we move on to 9 frames and select all lower points of the mask and move it down below the screen. Again, holding Shift. Let's do some adjustments to the shape again. Moving back to 4 frames. To add some details, let's create some small drops. We grab the pen tool and create 3 to 4 little drop-like shapes. Let me change the mask color quickly. Actually, we create one drop and then simply duplicate the mask. Command D is the shortcut. An adjusted shape. I mean, why do the same work twice, right? Let's add keyframes for all 4 mask shapes. Then press U to see the attributes with keyframes only. We need to move these keyframes of the main shape 1 frame to the right, because we want the small drops to drip down first. Let's select all the masks and move them up above the screen. Again, holding Shift while moving, and again, some little adjustments. I know, it's additional work that maybe doesn't seem necessary, but I think details are important. At 9 frames, these little drops are below the screen. Some little adjustments again, and we move those last keyframes 1 frame to the left or right, to increase randomness. Let's add more details. We move to 8 frames. The liquid probably doesn't cover all the screen. Let's add some holes here in between these big drops. Grabbing the pen tool, then we create a new mask, this time rather long and thin, changing the mask color again. And this time we subtract the mask to create a hole. We duplicate the mask and adjust it 4 times. Then we select all the blue masks and add a keyframe for the mask shape. Press U to see the keyframes only. Saves a lot of space in the timeline. Now let's move to the beginning and move these masks up and adjust them a little. Maybe we move these keyframes at the beginning 1 frame to the right. They need to start moving together with the green mask. Let's move this one here a bit higher. Then at 10 frames, we move them down out of the screen. Well, 11 frames is probably better. To add even more detail and liquid feel, we add the roughen edges effect. Set the border to 15. Let's hide the mask pass for now. crank up the scale to 500, reduce its complexity to 1. That's it. First half of the transition is done. Now we simply duplicate the solid by pressing Command D. Rename it Transition Out and move it to 11 frames in the timeline. Then we go into the Track Matte menu here and change it to Alpha Inverted Matte. The Transition Out solid is basically subtracted from the shape below, and that's how we simply make the shape disappear again. Let's move these small drops to the right. They need to move last now. And we need to subtract them as well. Wow, that was quick and easy. What do you all think? Let me know in the comments below. Wait, one last thing. We need to get rid of these white artifacts caused by the roughened edges effect, so we simply scale the two solids to 101%. Now you got all the basics, ready to create all kinds of new versions. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell if you want to know exactly when the next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. Hope that tutorial was useful for y'all. See you next time, guys. Bye!